Hi. Everybody knows what a comet looks like. Films, snapshots, videos of comets are easily found on the internet. But have you ever seen one of them on a dark night with your naked eye? For example, last year you probably heard about the Neowise comet. It is a comet discovered on March 27, 2020 by the Neowise Space Telescope. It reached perihelion on July 3rd and its closest point to Earth on July 23rd. A lot of people went out to take a look at that amazing comet. Here are some photos of the Neowise comet. Amazing, huh? What if I told you that a giant comet coming from the Oort cloud is approaching our solar system? Follow me in this video to get to know more about Comet Bernardinelli-Bernstein, also known as C2014UN271. So, we know pretty well what a comet looks like. But in order to talk about this fantastic newly discovered comet, we also need to know what a comet exactly is. In fact, it's hard, if you're not an astronomer, to distinguish between asteroids, comets, meteors, and so on. A comet is a body of ice, rock, and dust that can be several miles in diameter and orbits the Sun. Debris from comets is the source of many meteoroids. A meteoroid is a small rocky or metal object, usually between the size of a grain of sand or a boulder, that orbits the Sun. It originates from a comet or asteroid. A meteor is a meteoroid that enters the Earth's atmosphere and vaporizes, also called a shooting star. What would you wish if you saw one? A meteorite is a meteor that hits Earth without burning up in the atmosphere. A meteor shower is a collection of meteors visible when Earth passes through a trail of debris left by a comet. This is what you usually see in the sky in certain periods of the year. For example, the Perseids meteor shower in August. An asteroid is an object larger than a meteoroid that orbits the Sun and is made of rock or metal. Historically, objects larger than 10 meters have been called asteroids. Now that we understand the differences between all of these objects, let's talk about the news. A giant comet coming from the Oort cloud is coming towards us. The Oort cloud is a theoretical concept of a cloud of icy planetesimals. It was described for the first time by famous astronomer Jan Oort. He proposed the cloud surrounding the Sun at distances ranging from 0.03 to 3.2 light years. To date, we know Oort's cloud is divided into two regions, a disc-shaped inner Oort cloud that's called Hill's cloud and a spherical outer Oort cloud. Astronomers conjecture that the matter composing the Oort cloud formed closer to the Sun and was scattered far into space by gravitational effects of the giant planets early in the solar system's evolution. It's notable that, although no confirmed direct observations of the Oort cloud have been made, it may be the source that replenishes most long-period and Halley-type comets entering the inner solar system, and many of the Centaurs and Jupiter family comets as well. But what has the Oort cloud to do with comets? Well, actually, the outer Oort cloud is only loosely bound to the solar system, and thus is easily affected by the gravitational pull both of passing stars and of the Milky Way itself. These forces occasionally dislodge comets from their orbits within the cloud and send them toward the inner solar system. And that's exactly where our giant comet is coming from. C2014UN721, our comet, is 1,000 times more massive than a typical comet, making it potentially the largest ever found in modern times. At first glance, we didn't know it was a comet. Because of its enormous size, astronomers thought it could be something like a dwarf planet, but they soon realized they were wrong. They were instead facing a really big comet. So, the object has officially designated a comet on June 23rd, and it was called the Bernardinelli-Bernstein comet, after its discoverers, University of Pennsylvania graduate student Pedro Bernardinelli and astronomer Gary Bernstein. Do you want to know how big this comet is? This fantastic ice body is estimated to have a diameter of 62 miles to 124 miles, which makes it about 10 times wider than a typical comet. But the comet is far away from Earth, so this is a pretty rough estimation. The size of a comet far away from Earth is often calculated based on how much sunlight it reflects, and that's how we calculated its size. But we'll have to wait to know a better estimation of its real size. It could be bigger. It could be smaller. Anyway, among others, the orbital parameters of the object were studied. Astrodynamics tells us this fantastic comet will make its closest approach to our planet in 2031, but will remain at a quite large distance even then. We have the privilege of having discovered perhaps the largest comet ever seen, or at least larger than any well-studied one, and caught it early enough for people to watch it evolve as it approaches and warms up, Bernstein said. But how did they find it? Astronomers were taking a look at some archival images from the DES, the Dark Energy Survey. The Dark Energy Survey is an international collaborative effort to map hundreds of millions of galaxies, detect thousands of supernovae, and find patterns of cosmic structure that will reveal the nature of the mysterious dark energy that is accelerating the expansion of our universe. DES began searching the southern skies on August 31st, 2013. One of the highest performance wide-field CCD imagers in the world, DECAM was designed specifically for the DES and operated between 2013 and 2019. DECAM was built and tested at DOE's Fermi Lab. At present, DECAM is used for programs covering a huge range of science. DES was tasked with mapping 300 million galaxies across a 5,000 square degree area of the night sky. But during its 6 years of observation, it only observed many comets and trans-Neptunian objects passing through the surveyed field. A trans-Neptunian object, or TNO, is an icy body that resides in our solar system beyond the orbit of Neptune. Bernardinelli and Bernstein spotted the comet using the National Center for Supercomputing Applications and Fermilab, identifying 800 TNOs from archival survey data. At first, the images of the comet didn't show a classic tail between 2014 and 2018. But an independent observation in 2021, after the comet's existence was made public, showed the comet now has a coma of gas and dust surrounding it. Bingo. Let's see what we can say about the current position of the comet in our solar system. Comet Bernardinelli-Bernstein is currently located at the equivalent distance of Uranus, of about 20 astronomical units from the Sun. 1 AU is the Earth-Sun distance, about 93 million miles, or 150 million kilometers. Unluckily, the comet has a small brightness because it shines at magnitude 20. This means that if you're an amateur astronomer, it will be out of reach of your amateur telescope, and we are very sorry about that. Just for a term of comparison, most people can see objects of magnitude 5 or 6 with the naked eye in dark conditions. Remember that the magnitude scale is a little bit strange. A bigger magnitude corresponds to a lower brightness. So we said the comet is actually 20 AU distant from us. What will be its closest distance in the next coming years? When the comet swings closer to the Earth in 2031, it will still be at 11 AU. This means it will be just a little more distant than Saturn's orbit from the Sun. Even then, amateur sky watchers will still need to use very large telescopes to see it. This comet doesn't like to be papped. But what makes our Bernardinelli-Bernstein comet so special? The special thing about our giant comet is that it hasn't visited the inner solar system in 3 million years. At that time, our famous ancestor Lucy was still walking on Earth. What will happen next? Comet Bernardinelli-Bernstein will, of course, be followed by the astronomical community because we need to understand the composition and origin of this massive object. Also, there may be many more undiscovered comets of this size waiting in the Oort cloud far beyond Pluto and the Kuiper Belt. And they could give us a better understanding of the evolution and birth of our solar system. Since these giant comets are thought to have been scattered to the far reaches of the solar system by the migration of Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune early in their history, finding huge objects like Comet Bernardinelli-Bernstein is crucial to our understanding of the early history of our planetary system. Some of you may ask, we know we can send probes of comets, exactly as we did with the Rosetta mission. So will the astronomical community send spacecraft on this giant comet? Well, this is hard to say, and it's hard to predict. Space missions tend to be shorter than the lifespans of ground-based scopes. But it still remains possible that a future telescope or mission could be funded by 2031 for comet observations that are not yet approved or even planned. The major space agencies may also task existing spacecraft across the solar system to look at Comet Bernardinelli-Bernstein, as happened near Mars in 2014 when Comet Sighting Spring zoomed past the red planet. Meanwhile, we can feast our eyes with these spectacular images from the approaching on the surface of the comet 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko from the Rosetta mission. The Rosetta mission goal was initially set for the rendezvous with the comet 46P Virtanen. After the postponement of the initial launch, a new target was set, comet 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko. On its 10-year journey to the comet, the spacecraft also passed by two asteroids. Rosetta's main objective was to rendezvous with and inter-orbit around comet 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko, performing observations of the comet's nucleus and coma. On November 12, 2014, at 17:32 GMT, Rosetta's Philae lander made the first ever landing on a comet. This video ends here. Thanks for watching, everyone. What are your thoughts on this video? Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to share. Science needs you, and you need science. See you next time for another amazing video.